is this culture of fame, of narcissism, of obsessed with the camera, and what is it? What are you going to do for me? How is it all about me? And you introduce us to a lovely man by the name of Chris. Tell us a little bit about him before we double play.
We do have a generation that I think we have raised with a great degree of empowerment, where it's like, the world owes me a living, and we pick this perfect example story of a kid that says, I want to be a rock star. I say, yeah, he's now 40 years old. I want to be a rock star. And has basically tried to buy fame, has bled his family, his mother and father, for $1.7 million. $1.7 million trying to be a rock star. I mean, he's got the poses, he's got the haircut, he's got everything, but so entitled that he is won't take a job because it's not a rock star job. And it's just such a poser.
There's also a dark side of online influencing. Take the large number of fake accounts that some influencers have following them.
It's a shortcut that plenty of people are tempted to take, and so they're tempted to do it, but it's always a bad idea.
A recent report reveals companies paid out $744 million to Instagram influencers last year alone. But $102 million of that money, meant to reach legitimate followers, was actually spent on fake accounts.
The whole point of being an influencer is that you have influence. If everyone following you is not a real person, you don't have any influence. You just have a bunch of followers.
Followers. Hey, I don't got nothing against no producers. I mean, everybody got their props when they want to be producers. You know what I'm saying? It's just that this man can't be me and I can't be him. You know what I'm saying?
That's to me is a shock. Expressing themselves, but then when they have their shows and stuff, they got to live up to that image because they're drawing a crowd that's on some rah-rah.
Champagne wishes and caviar dreams, dick and cream, with shells and fish scales from triple beams.
Clout war.
Champagne wishes and caviar dreams, dick and cream, with shells and fish scales from triple beams.
Clout war.
Champagne wishes and caviar dreams. Dick and cream with shells and fish scales from triple beams.
Clout war. same wishes and caviar dreams. Getting cream with sales and fish scale from triple beams. Clout war.
How far would you go for attention? Trying to go viral appears to be what led to the death of this young man. He's died in Halstead, Minnesota yesterday. His aunt telling us he was trying to film a stunt that involved shooting a gun to a book he was holding. He was doing it in the hopes of becoming internet famous.
Others to try and follow in the steps of any popular internet personalities because they say fame on the internet is fleeting and usually something you can't make a career out of.
Yeah. Some young people who post selfies are likely seeking attention, positive feedback, and social validation. They may be relying too much on the response of others. The selfie indulgence may be like a drug. There's a high and ultimately a low.
Getting 300 likes, that's not really going to last for you. Says something about that person that they maybe really don't feel good about themselves deep down.
Une étrange boule de lumière tombe en éclat juste à mes pieds et tous ces débris de verre en sort un papillon doré.
Anyway, I'd like to take this time out to bow before his divine majesty.
Today I want to focus on an equally large and growing disease. This is one I don't believe the WHO has recognized as a pandemic yet, but it's not far off, I imagine. It's called clout chasing. This shit is wild. People are dying, people are becoming dumber, all in the pursuit of internet clout.
There was even an app a few years ago that would rate your clout and give you a clout score. This was based on your social platforms, followers, retweets, blog engagement, and influence. The higher the number, the more clout. It's something many strive for: impact, recognition, and power. Clout. It's all about influence.
Loretta. Yeah. Where your money at? Look, where your money at? 50s in your hundreds at? Drop my new shit, tore the world, then was double back. Where your money at? Where your money at? Look. Money at 50s in your hundreds at. Drop my new shit, tore the world, then was double back. Where your money at? Where your money at? Look. Drop my new shit, tore the world, then was double back. Where your money at? Where your money at?
Thank you. a time for soul searching in social media businesses, and you were part of building the largest one. What soul searching are you doing right now on that?
I feel tremendous guilt. I think we all knew in the back of our minds, even though we feigned this whole line of like, there probably aren't any really bad unintended consequences. I think in the back, deep, deep recesses of our minds, we kind of knew something bad could happen. But I think the way we defined it was not like this. It literally is a point now where I think we have created tools that are ripping apart the social fabric of how society works. That is truly where we are. And I would encourage all of you as the future leaders of the world to really internalize how important this is. If you feed the beast, that beast will destroy you. If you push back on it, we have a chance to control it and rein it in. And it is a point in time where people need to hard break from some of these tools and the things that you rely on. The short-term dopamine-driven feedback loops that we have created are destroying how society works.
Loretta.
Was all about how do we consume as much of your time and conscious attention as possible. It's a social validation feedback loop because you're exploiting a vulnerability in human psychology. We understood this consciously, and we did it anyway.